This is a futuristic look at recycling, taking materials we no longer need or want and making something useful. Wood chips, tires, and biosolids are brought to this Lebanon plant. Waste is fed through, but not burned or incinerated. Rather, the materials are sent through a gasification system, heated and changed. The plant converts waste into electricity to power Lebanon's wastewater treatment facility just across the road. And the entire gasification process keeps some 8,000 tons of waste a year from ending up in a landfill.
Well, the real cool thing is everything that comes into this facility is either converted to energy or a useful product.
And we believe that the best solution for the ever-increasing amount of waste that we have in the world is to convert it to clean energy. And that's what we wanted to do here, and that's what we were able to put together with the City of Lebanon.
Mike Webb with Ares Clean Energy says other municipalities are now looking at the Lebanon plant, a standout because of its efficiency.
It's 3,000 degrees inside the gasifier. There's a thermochemical breakdown. There's not any oxygen inside. Two things come out. One is fuel gas, and the other is the biochar.
Biochar is this grainy black substance, much like charcoal. It can be used in industry and agriculture, containing nutrients to improve crops and forage.
This facility is able to take in some 60 tons of waste a day, and it could produce upwards of 3 tons of biochar in 24 hours.
Biochar has great potential as a soil amendment. Biochar is a carbon-rich material.
Dr. Forbes Walker is a soil scientist who has consulted the gasification plant. He calls the plant and the energy and biochar it produces a win-win proposition for the city and Tennessee farming.
When we apply it to the soil, it can improve the soil physical properties, the soil chemical properties, and the soil biology. It can stimulate a lot of the soil biology that's going on. So it's a kind of lots of potential to improve the quality and the health of our soils.
Lebanon hopes to be a zero landfill city. This plant goes a long way in helping to reach that goal. And it's not only what's eliminated here, it's also what's created. This is Charles Denny reporting.